Hi, I'm Nikki Jabor, and today I want to offer you some tips on caring for your mid to late summer flower gardens and containers. Summer is all about maintenance and making sure your plants have adequate moisture, nutrients, and dead flowers are removed to prolong the blooming period. Here's what you need to know about caring for your mid to late summer flower garden. One of the biggest tasks to remember in the summer garden is to deadhead annual and perennial flowers. This is just the act of removing the spent flowers, and it's important because leaving dead flowers on the plants can reduce the amount of new flowers that are produced. I use my mini garden shears to quickly and easily pop off those spent flowers. For most perennials and annuals, I don't advise trying to pick off the dead flowers by hand, as the stems can be stubborn and hard to remove, resulting in damage to the plants. The exception to this is removing the spent flowers of daylilies. They come off very easily by hand. If you have newly planted perennials, it's a good idea to keep an eye on soil moisture. I would give these plants a deep watering weekly if there has been no rain and the weather has been hot and dry. Once perennials are established, they shouldn't need irrigation unless there's a prolonged drought. In spring, I top dress my perennial garden with compost and a granular organic flower fertilizer. But now that it's midsummer, it's too late to feed perennials. A late fertilizing can promote fresh new growth, which might sound good, but it won't have time to harden off before the temperature drops in late autumn and can damage the plant. Compost, on the other hand, well, it's always a good idea. So if you have plenty of compost, you can add a thin layer around your perennial plants, even in mid to late summer. As for summer container garden care, keep watering regularly, probably every day or two, to ensure the plants have lots of moisture. Frequent watering, however, does flush out nutrients from the soil, so I give my pots and hanging baskets a dose of a liquid organic flower fertilizer every 2 weeks. One of the best parts of having a garden is planting flowers for bouquets. I grow a wide variety of perennials, annuals, grasses, even herbs for cutting. And if you want your bouquets to last the longest, make sure you cut them at the right time of day. That's not when it's hot and sunny and dry in mid to late afternoon. The best time to cut flowers is early morning when the temperatures are cooler and the stems are full of moisture. I use garden shears or hand pruners to clip the stems, trying to cut back to a fresh set of buds. This promotes plenty of new flowers for future bouquets. I also bring a jar or a container of water up to the garden with me so I can immediately place the stems into water. For single stem flowers like dahlias, sunflowers, and zinnias, I clip the fully open flowers. For plants that form flower spikes, like snapdragons and salvia, I pick when the bottom buds have begun to open. Once you finish cutting your flowers, bring them indoors and give each stem a fresh cut at an angle to help them absorb more water. I also use lukewarm water for my arrangement, not cold, as lukewarm water is absorbed faster by the plants and can prolong the life of the arrangement. Place it in a spot that's away from direct light, but where you'll enjoy it. Happy growing!